King of glory, the Lord, strong and mighty, the Lord, mighty in battle. He is our King of glory. Be still and know that I am God. I am exalted among nations. I am exalted in the earth. We have now our scripture and prayer by Reverend Will Pittman III.
Good evening. Reading Psalms 95, verses 1 through 6. I will read it from the New King James Version. And it reads, O come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout joyfully to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving. Let us shout joyfully to him with psalms. For the Lord is the great God, and the great King above all gods. In his hand are the deep places of the earth. The heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands formed the dry land. Oh, come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker.
Hallelujah.
May God give a blessing to the reading and the hearers and the doers of his word. Please bow with me as we go to our Father in prayer. Father God, we come to you now. We just thank you, Father, for this amazing week that we've had with E.C. Morris Ministry Institute, Father God. It has been so much knowledge passed around, Father God. We have been able to come from far and near to be able to come together and worship and praise your holy name. Father God, we have come together on so many occasions to do what you have called us to do. Father God, we just thank you for everything that you allowed to happen this week, everything that you had already ordained to happen. Father God, we know that because of you, this has been the success that it has been. Father God, and there's no other way to wrap this E.C. Morris Ministry Institute up, Father God, but such amazing voices that will come to our spirit. We ask you, Father, to clear our minds and clear our hearts of anything that's not of you, Father God. And we just ask you, Father, that when these songs are sang, Father God, that we will allow your message to resonate in our hearts and our minds. We know, Father God, there may not be a spoken word today, but your word will come through song. And we just ask you, Father, to bless our hearts. Give us what we need tonight. Give us what we need so when we leave here tonight, we can remember everything that you taught us this week. Everything to go out and build up your kingdom, Father God. It's your kingdom, it's not ours. We don't own anything, it all belongs to you. We give it all back to you, Father God, and we just ask you, Father, to tell us what you need for us to do, because it's your will and it's your way. We are just the vessels that you use to get your work done. So, Father God, as I continue to stand before you to do your work, we just ask you right now to take and remove anything that Satan has set before us. We place it at your feet. We ask your Father to deal with it how you need to deal with it so we can set back to hear your message through this amazing choir that has prepared to render your message through song. We ask your Father all of these things. We ask for your blessings, but we ask for it, Father, in the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords' name. We ask for it all in Jesus' name. Let us all say, amen.
We're going to ask this wonderful choir to lead the congregation in singing the congregational hymn. And we're going to ask you to stand as they lead us.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is. Thank you.
Thank you. Is Sister Hart here? There she is. Nobody can do it like her. I was thinking you weren't here. God bless you.
To our Institute Coordinator, Reverend Clifton Conley, to our clinician and our Mr. Master of Ceremonies, Reverend Willingham, Reverend Midas Miles, who's our board chairman, Sister Cynthia Perkins, President of the National Alumni Association, clergy, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. We want you to know that our hearts are overflowing with inexpressible joy because you are here. We are grateful to Pastor Dennis Edwards and the St. John congregation for always opening their doors up to us. And so, ladies and gentlemen, in behalf of our esteemed coordinator and the E.C. Morris Board, it is with a sense of gratitude and appreciation that we welcome you here tonight. At this time, it is my distinct pleasure to introduce the School of Sacred Music Concert Choir and just tell you a little bit about its history. As you know, sacred music has always been an integral part of worship in our black churches. Ephesians 5th chapter, the 19th through the 20th verse reads, "Speak to one another with praise, hymns, and spiritual songs." You know, sacred music helps us to elevate our thoughts toward God and not ourselves. Different types of sacred music is used in churches to reach the various people in our church congregations. Hymns and also contemporary music, it teaches theology that comes straight out of Scripture. Because of the desire to meet the spiritual needs of the entire church body, there was a need to increase the music repertoire in our churches. And so, in 1994, the E.C. Morris Department was created and named in honor of Mrs. Edith King Flakes. In case you might ask, who is she? Well, Mrs. Flakes was a talented Christian woman and esteemed musician. She attended Washington, D.C. Conservatory of Music and Howard University School of Music. She was a choir director and organist at Mount Pleasant Baptist Church, where she faithfully served for many years. She conducted instrumental, solo, and choir cantatas. Every year, she would present Handel's Messiah for her church and the community as well. As a choir member of Arkansas Baptist College, I had the privilege of singing in the Messiah. You know, Ms. Flakes was later joined by her friend and esteemed musician, Mrs. Hazel Shanks Henson. Because of their devotion to music, in 1998, the E.C. Morris Music Department was renamed E.K. Flakes and Hazel Henson's School of Sacred Music. In case somebody might ask, Mrs. Hazel Henson received a degree in music with an emphasis in piano from Atlanta University. She also attended the Juilliard School of Music. She was an esteemed pianist and choir director at Mount Zion Baptist Church, pianist for the state and national Baptist Convention, and director of the concert choir at Arkansas Baptist College. Students from Arkansas Baptist College got an opportunity to travel on the bus in and out of the state on choir tours. They would perform at churches and change into beautiful gowns during intermission. I remember those choir days because I was one of those students. It is a blessing from God, choir directors and choir members from churches in Little Rock, North Little Rock, and other towns to attend the Edith K. Flakes and Hazel Henson music workshops. These songs, just like tonight, are taught to choir members in their local churches when they get back by well-known music clinicians. The concert tonight is named in honor of Elizabeth K. Willingham. She was the wife of Reverend Willingham, in case you might ask. Mrs. Willingham was the beautiful wife, like I said, of Reverend Robert Willingham, her pastor. She was a Tuskegee graduate, public school teacher, college instructor at Arkansas Baptist College, and a teacher in the Union District Congress of Christian Education. Mrs. Willingham was a devout music lover. She played the piano and she supported the School of Sacred Music arduously. After her passing in 2003, the E.C. Morris Board of Directors named the concert in honor of her memory. Because of her dedication and faithfulness to the Edith K. Flakes and Hazel Henson School of Sacred Music. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, may I present to you the Elizabeth K. Willingham Memorial Concert and their great clinician, I know you know her, Mrs. Beatrice Jackson.
Give him glory! Give him honor! give them glory.
Thank you, Lord.
That's a good place to tell them thank you. Hallelujah. I wish I had some praises on this side.
Hallelujah.
Why not praise us? When I think of his goodness, I'm on choir. Come on, tell him one more time.
Nobody but Jesus. Of your goodness, Jesus.
Thank you, choir, for the first part of the concert. Take up a little offering, and you can make it a big offering if you want to. The Bible says, "What shall I render to the Lord?" Moreover, it is required of a steward to be faithful. Brother Brooks, I want to just say this, Brooks. I tell you, you got these ushers top notch. I pastored three churches in Virginia, one in Pine Bluff, and one in Little Rock. And I've never seen a director of usher any smoother than you. It's just a blessing, man, to see you walk and see how you handle the ushers and the lifting of the offering for God. Brother Brooke, thank you. He asked me to lift it. And I said, you know, you're such a professional, and you know the church house and everything. I said, I'm just going to turn the offering over to you when that time comes. Brother Brooke.
Thank you.
that if you wanted to make a checkout, and it's not too late, just a minute, if it's not too late, and make it out to the E.C. Morris Ministers Institute. The pastor of this lovely church told me to say that to you. Offer right sacrifice and put your trust in the Lord. Psalms 4:3. What shall I render unto the Lord? I shall render as he has blessed me. Let us pray. Infinite Spirit, Holy God, obedient, we thank you for this privilege of honoring and serving you. We thank you for the gifts that your people have brought to the altar in order that the E.C. Morris Ministers Institute may continue to bring praises and glory and messages in your name. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, we pray. Amen.
Thank you. finally know he saved your soul.
Come on, Pastor Benny, and lead this.
Thank you.
Oh, no.
all this anointing. You don't know the cost of my hallelujah. You don't know the cost of my thank you, Jesus. You don't know the many tears I had to cry. Can I get a witness out there? You don't know how they lied on me, talked about. You don't know the oil, 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 the oil on my life. It's more than a gift. It's more than a gift. It's more than a gift.
Yeah.
say that.
You don't know my story. You don't know my story.
Ha. One more time.
By the Lord, I had to call on Jesus. Somebody had an addiction, you need to call on Jesus. Somebody had cancer in your body, you need to call on Jesus. Somebody got high blood pressure, you need to call on Jesus.
Of the oil.
the voices that we have heard. Thank God for this choir. Thank God. Look at your neighbor. You don't know your neighbor's story. You don't know what they've been through, but thank God. It doesn't matter. We've all been through a story. But the Bible says that we got one Lord, one faith, and one baptism. I don't know the cost, what it cost you, but I know what it cost God. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, and whosoever believeth on him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. The one that believes that he died and was crucified on Calvary, buried and raised from the dead 3 days later, shall have everlasting life. And if you believe that today, there is room at God's cross for you. The door of God's church is open to you. Maybe you've already believed, and maybe you just need to be reconnected to the faith. Maybe you strayed away. Maybe you've been distant. That's okay, because the door to God's church is still open to you. Will you come? Maybe you just need a good church home. Well, you need to be connected to some assembly of saints. Well, that's okay, too. The door of God's church is open to you as well. Father, we have done as you have commanded, and yet there is room. Amen.
And I am the distinct privilege of presenting our illustrious coordinator that has brought us a great institute this week, the Reverend Dr. Clifton Conley.
We are most privileged and grateful for the opportunity we've had this evening to worship through the ministry of singing. Someone has said that singing is the creativity of one who has a voice to sing. And certainly, this institute choir has lifted their voices and have been created, has provided creativity through singing. And I want to thank Sister Jackson for leading a great time. Thank you. We found ourselves in a crisis. Our clinician, the late Darius Nelson of St. Mark Baptist Church, went home, and the Lord provided us with a ram in the bush and Sister Jackson, and we thank her for leading. Let me say, it has been a great week, a spiritual week and a financial week, and the Lord just keep blessing the institution with gifts. And we want to thank the Howards tonight, Deacon Howard and Sister Howard. Thank you for your gift of $1,000. We thank you so much to help Arkansas Baptist College. We're blessed with the presence of our National Baptist Women's President of the National Baptist Convention. I'm going to ask Dr. Smith, would you stand? She is a native of Detroit, Michigan, and thank you. And we're blessed with the presence of our state president. Sister Billings, would you stand? Thank you. Blessed with our state president, the Reverend Dr. D.L. Richardson of the Consolidated, would you stand? And we're blessed with the pastor and first lady of the St. John Missionary Baptist Church, the first and the pastor. Thank you for opening your doors. Let me say, I know some committee members or local committee members, are you here? Would you please stand? I know there are some in the back, but would you please stand? Thank you. It's been a team effort this week. You all have done a great job, and I appreciate your support throughout the week. Thank all of these choir members tonight. Thank you all so much for a great job. Thank Pastor Jackson for leading our men on Tuesday night. And we said thank you. We have already given you a nickname. We call you Benny and the Men. Benny and the Men. So thank you. Thank you so much to all that have gathered in this place. We thank you. Amen. We're praying for the safe arrival of those that left today, that they will arrive home safely. Yes. And I want to say thank you for the privilege for of serving and serving as your coordinator. I want to thank Pastor Willingham, whom we call Dr. Bob, for passing the baton to me to lead this institute. And we're most grateful and privileged. Yes. And we thank our president, Sister Favors, for leading the institution, Arkansas Baptist College, in a great way. Amen. Did I forget anything? We're ready to go home. Get right, church, and let's go home. Thank St. John's security team as well.
Shall come to pass, either at sunrise or sunset, there must always be the changing of the guards. May we all say, amen, amen.
For these musicians, amen, and Pastor Maurice Tatum, amen.